Good morning, children. In our previous session, we have read chapter Fritz till page number 15. We have read the description of Jayanto's doll, Fritz, which his uncle had brought for him from Switzerland. And the man who sold him had jokingly told Jayanto's uncle to call the doll by the name Fritz. Now we will continue with page number 15, last paragraph. But before that, let me tell you that by the end of this video, you will be able to understand Jayanto's obsession about Fritz. You will be able to understand how Fritz was destroyed. And you will be able to unfold the mystery of the Deodar tree. So let us start with page number 15, paragraph last. Jayanto said, "I had a lot of toys when I was small. My parents gave me practically everything I wanted. Perhaps because I was their only child. But once I had Fritz, I forgot all my toys." Now this particular paragraph, children, is going to let us know how much obsessed Jayanto was with his doll, Fritz. "I played only with him. A time came when I began to spend hours just talking to him. Our conversation had to be one-sided. Why had the conversation to be one-sided? Because Fritz was a doll and could not reply. Still, Jayanto kept on talking to it for hours. Of course, but Fritz had such a funny smile on his lips and such a look in his eyes that it seemed to me as though he could understand every word." Now these lines about Fritz, children, it tells us that there was something mysterious about Fritz. "Sometimes I wondered," underline the word wondered, it means thought. "Sometimes I wondered if he would actually converse with me, if I could speak to him in German." So this is what Jayanto believed, that Fritz could answer him if he knew German. "Now it seems like a childish fantasy." This thought of his now seems to him like a childish fantasy. Fantasy means imagination. "But at that time means during his childhood, the whole thing was very real to me. My parents did warn me not to overdo the things." Overdo means not to be over involved with Fritz. "But I listened to no one. I had not yet been put in a school, so I had all the time in the world for Fritz." So this paragraph tells us how much obsessed Jayanto was with his doll, Fritz. After narrating this to Shankar, Jayanto fell silent. "I, who is I here, children?" It is Shankar, the narrator. "I looked at my watch and realized it was 9:30 p.m. It was very quiet outside. We were sitting in the drawing room of the circuit house. An oil lamp burnt in the room. I asked, who is I again, children? It is Shankar. I asked, what happened to the doll? Jayanto was still deep in thought. His answer to my question came so late that by that time I had started to think that he had not heard me at all. So what does this mean? Jayanto was lost in his thought when Shankar asked me what happened to the doll. He gave the answer, but he gave it quite late. Now what does he reply? He says, I had brought it to Bundi. Now Bundi, children, is the same place where Shankar and Jayanto are at present. It was destroyed here. Destroyed here? What was destroyed? Fritz. Destroyed? How? Shankar wanted to know how Fritz was destroyed. Jayanto sighed. Underline the word sighed, children. It means took a deep breath. So Jayanto took a deep breath and narrated what had happened years ago and how Fritz was destroyed. We were sitting out on the lawn having tea. I had kept the doll by my side on the grass. I was not really old enough to have tea. That means Jayanto was quite young and he was not old enough to have tea. But he still insisted. And in the process, the cup tilted and some of the hot tea fell on my pants. That means Some of the hot tea fell on Jayanto's pants. I ran inside to change and came back to find that Fritz had disappeared. I looked around and found quite soon that a couple of stray dogs were having a nice tug of war with Fritz. Now, what is this tug of war, children? It is a game played by two players when the thing is dragged by each. Although he didn't actually come apart, his face was battered. Now, his has been used for Fritz. Whose face was battered? It is Fritz. So, battered means badly damaged. Although he didn't actually come apart, his face was badly damaged, that is battered, beyond recognition, and his clothes were torn. In other words, Fritz did not exist for me anymore. He was dead. Look at this line, children. Fritz was dead. Now, we know that Fritz is a non-living thing and it cannot die. Still, it has been given the quality of a living being. So, it is personification. Dead word is used for the doll. Now, on listening to this, Jayanto was very much intrigued. He was curious. He wanted to know what happened afterwards. So, he asked, and then Jayanto's story intrigued me. What is the meaning of intrigued? It means curious. Jayanto had intrigued Shankar very much. So, Shankar asked, and then, what could possibly happen after that? Now, this is what Jayanto says. What could possibly happen after that? After someone has died, his funeral had to be arranged. I arranged his funeral. Funeral, children, it means the observances held for a dead person before his burial. So, Jayanto arranged for the funeral. Shankar asks, meaning? I buried him under that deodar tree. Mind you, children, it is the same deodar tree he had seen earlier, right? So, I had buried him under that deodar tree. I had wanted to make a coffin. Underline the word coffin, children. It means a box for burying a corpse, that is a dead body. So, Jayanto wanted to make a coffin for Fritz. Fritz was, after all, a European, so he needed a funeral. But I could find nothing, not even a little box. So, in the end, I buried him just like that. Just like that means without a coffin. At last, the mystery of the deodar tree was solved. So, in this way, narrator could understand what was so important in that deodar tree. We went to bed at around 10. Our room was a large one and our beds had been neatly made. Not being used to doing a lot of walking, I was feeling rather tired. Who do you think is I here, children? Yes, it is Shankar. So, I was feeling rather tired after the day's activities. Besides, the bed was very comfortable. So, Shankar felt that the bed was very comfortable and he was very much tired after the day's activities. Therefore, he fell asleep barely 10 minutes after hitting the pillow. A slight noise woke me up a little later. Underline this complete line, children. A slight noise. It is auditory imagery. I turned on my side and found Jayanto sitting up on his bed. Now, Shankar woke up and saw Jayanto was sitting up on his bed. The table lamp by his bed was switched on, and in its light, it was easy to see the look of anxiety on his face. Whose face? Who is it? It is Jayanto's face. This line creates a mysterious and eerie atmosphere. Underline and write down. It was easy to see the look of anxiety on his face, mysterious and eerie atmosphere. I asked, what is it? Are you not feeling well? Shankar asked Jayanto if he was not feeling well. Instead of answering my question, Jayanto asked me one himself. That means Jayanto did not answer the question of Shankar, but he asked him one more question. What was it? Do you think the circuit house has got small animals? I mean, things like cats or mice? I shouldn't be surprised if it does. Why? Yes, the circuit house may have cats or mice. Now, Jayanto says, something walked over my chest. That's what woke me. So he says that he has got woken up by some animal like cat or mice. He felt that something had walked over his chest. Now Shankar says, rats and mice usually come in through drains, but I have never known them to be climbing on the bed. This is the second time I have woken up. Actually, who is I here, children? It is Jayanto. So it was not the first time that Jayanto had woken up. It was the second time he had woken up. The first time I had heard a shuffling noise near the window. So the first time he had heard a shuffling noise, that is moving or changing voice, near the window. Underline this complete line, children. It is again auditory imagery. Oh, if it was near the window, it is more likely to be a cat. This is what Shankar feels. Shankar feels if Jayanto had heard a voice near the window, then it is most probably of a cat. To this, Jayanto replies, yes, but he has got some problem in this answer. And he says, but. This is all for the day today, children. You will have to read the same pages again. Thank you.